record. So at this point, I'm recording, just not streaming.
Okay.
So shame on everybody else that wants to watch us. Unfortunately, that's not going to happen tonight.
That's missing episode.
For Twitch, yes, unfortunately. But it won't be missing from archives.
Yes. Should we roll force die?
We will in a minute.
Okay.
Rocky just stepped away.
Okay.
Was it Rocky or was it a?
It was John. John. I'm here.
El John.
It took a while to load, yeah.
Maybe if we get a lot of light sides, it won't matter. We'll just destroy them anyway. No, not really.
Yeah, I'm getting pretty rough ping off everybody right now.
Yeah, Rocky's at 461. What am I at? I don't know.
Spiked around 600.
Done. Yeah, same. Yeah, John's spiking up as well.
Everybody's spiking on my end. It is my end, not anybody else's. I mean, there might be interference from you other guys, but I'm like, every once in a while, it'll just peg up into the, like, the 400-500s and then come back down to 74.
You know, yeah.
It's, my connection is spotty at best right now, which is why I was debating delaying it completely. But.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, anybody who's here and is physically able, go ahead and give me a force roll die, please.
One dark side.
Again?
Yep.
Oh, my die lagged. Oh, no, it lagged, and now it's two fucking dark side.
Woohoo! John, Cody, you're our only hope.
It is me. The hope.
The last hope.
It is the hope.
What did Cody get?
We have a combined total of three dark sides so far.
I've got a ping of 999. How many dark side does Cody have?
I got two.
And John got one. So we now have
six dark side. Now that is a destiny rule.
No mucho, muchas gracias.
I blame Tempest.
Here, make the tokens really big.
Say, this is how much you suck. Look at it.
Are there other tokens here? For anyone else?
No, there's just six here for me.
I have everybody spiking at like a full
I've
second.
I've got like nine. Now there's like 12. Oh, okay. Now, oh, okay.
Yes, my
now
connection.
Now they're massive.
And my connection is absolutely fucking shit. The less we have to do on the board, probably the better.
Yeah.
But we are now recording for posterity. Posterity, excuse me. And we're going to attempt to get some headway tonight because I feel really bad. I'm here, I'm present, but it's just my connection is just absolute fucking dog shit. So,
Man, I don't feel bad.
I do feel
connections
bad.
Just suck.
Yeah. Anyway, we've covered what we think is our plan at this point in time before this recording started. So. We're just going to jump straight into it. Bortuna.
Hi.
You're being led down a hall. The Imperial officer is ahead of you. Two stormtroopers are behind you, you know, on either, you know, basically on your flanks. You have been handcuffed, and they couldn't find a gag.
So where are we going?
To Ryloth.
No, I mean, like, where are we going right now?
To Ryloth.
Okay.
This journey will be so much more pleasant for you and for me if you would keep the talking to a minimum.
I think the only person this is going to be pleasant for is you.
Excuse me?
So, like, do I not have to go if I talk about the thing?
No, no, you'll go one way or the other.
Even if I talk about the thing?
At this point in time, I'm not even sure if you know what the thing is.
I guess you'll never find out then, will you?
This would be so much easier if you had a gag. You are escorted to a turbo lift. It is large enough for the four of you, basically, and that's about it. Hang on.
Oh boy.
You're brought down the turbo lift, and your doors open up, and you're back onto the main concourse where you were. And they're escorting you to a hangar. The three of you.
Oh boy.
Have just gotten notification that the shuttle was incoming.
Okay. I'll say Bumbles would look up after we switch off the communicator. He'd look at Arden. Say, "All right, Arden. It's going to be pretty suspicious if all three of us go down to that hangar and scout it out. You don't have to go in the hangar. Just like hang around outside and get a view of what's going on in there. If there's not a lot, about 6-7 maybe troops, maybe less than that, hopefully, then we attack, get more tuna, get out of Dodge. If there's more than that, just come back and let us, we'll have communicators, so you just let us know and we'll get ready to go. Maybe we'll meet up with Bruce before he leaves. Maybe he'll tag along. Maybe he really wants to get to his contact. I don't know. Does that sound like a good idea to you?"
Sure.
Okay.
All right.
Java.
Java just kind of shrugs with his arms up. You know, like, you know, his hands up. And...
All right. Make sure you, he like gestures to his neck. Maybe take off the helmet. Maybe it'll make him less suspicious. I don't know.
Why would they be suspicious if I had my helmet on?
Well, if, I don't know, if they have, like, the guy who interrogated you there, some Imperial Stormtrooper saw you there, in the interrogation, then yeah, I don't know. More of a precaution thing than anything else. But yeah, it's up to you. I want to get on this soon, though. I don't know when that thing will land.
I guess I'll go scout the area.
Alright.
So you're leaving the ship, sir?
Yeah.
Okay.
Communicator synced.
As you step off the ship, there's not a whole lot of anything going on right at the moment. Activity hasn't picked up. Activity hasn't dropped off. It's as it has been since you have arrived at the station. Give me a perception check. One difficulty. Please.
I'm not at all prepared. Let me open my character test. Where the heck is... Okay, there it is.
You should have two yellows and a green.
Yeah, I got it.
Nice.
Three success. One advantage.
As you look around, as you exit the ship, you're not seeing an increase in the stormtrooper activity whatsoever. It still looks like there is, you know, the stormtrooper sweep group of, the three stormtroopers with their equipment. It looks like they're scanning a different ship that has come in the interim. There is one stormtrooper, standing at the entrance area to the hangar, relaxed.
Alright. I guess I'll make my way out of the hangar and just down towards Hangar 12. And just
are you
poke my head in.
Are you attempting to be stealthy? Are you attempting to be casual? Are you just attempting casual. Guns blazing?
Casual.
This is not a stealth check per se, but it's still going to be a stealth check. It's a matter of how much attention you're getting, kind of a thing. So it's not like a straight stealth as you're thinking. It is one difficulty for me, please.
Oh boy.
Three advantage.
Alright, well, you think that you're being, you know, casual about things. What would you say that your three advantages could do for you in this situation? What can be advantages for you?
The only people looking at him are hot chicks.
Okay. Unfortunately, the definition of hot chick varies from species to species, and you're currently being glared at by what you think are... you think they're human, but they're not quite human. Hard to tell at this distance.
Okay. But my question, if the player said hot chicks, then wouldn't that imply that the player would just think so?
Again, that depends on the definition of the species.
You see three female Gamorreans looking at you.
Well, no, it wouldn't depend on the species. If John was the one who said it, that means it would be his subjective opinion.
But John didn't say it. Chaba did.
A rocky.
I'm a furry. It's canon.
Oh. Okay. We now know.
Poor Harden.
I wish we were streaming when I said that. the greatest line I've ever uttered around streaming.
And it's not streaming. As you make your way towards Hangar 12, what would you like to do?
Remember, John.
Nothing from the peanut gallery. Just, nothing this wasn't from the peanut gallery.
Damn it. A funny joke.
I was just going to poke my head in, just take a quick look, and just walk on by, just as if I'm just...
Give me a perception check. One difficulty.
Nice.
Two success.
As you attempt to casually stroll into this hangar and bring as little attention to yourself as possible, you take a quick look around. The main doors are open. Sometimes they're open, sometimes they're closed. It all depends on the size of the shuttle. This time they're flat out open. You think you see a Lambda class shuttle coming into the hangar. You see, standing at attention around one of the landing spots that's closest to the entrance which you've come into, another four stormtroopers. Not like a military, you know, welcome, but it looks like they're standing ready for whoever or whatever may come off that shuttle.
Ah, I'm just gonna take a, just turn my head, look at the other ships, and just go on back out.
Give me another stealth, this time with 2 difficulty.
So fly.
Okay.
4 success, 4 threat.
Again, you feel like you've made your way around in a non-threatening, non-intrusive way. As you approach the... Really? Rocky is gone again. I don't even know why I schedule a game if you keep getting pulled away.
I just want to pop, man. Jeez.
As you approach the door back to Hangar 13, you are surrounded by 4 near-human women that start complimenting you on your armor and are you some kind of famous bounty hunter? And they start asking you 1.5 million questions.
Thank you. No, I just got it. What's going on here? What's
They think your armor's sexy.
He thinks my armor's sexy.
Thank you.
They're just kind of swarmed on you, kind of a thing. I see that. I would like for you to give me a perception check at 3 difficulty now.
Oh.
What would you like a mechanical triumph to be in this situation?
One of them's actually hot.
This isn't your scene, Chaba.
I don't know, I'm just trying to help.
What did you say they were?
Near humans.
Near human?
Near humans. Maybe one of them has like a forehead ridge, not like a Klingon, but kind of like a V, almost. It starts in the middle of the brow and then goes up into the hairline. You know, not across the temples, but higher up towards the peak of the head. Maybe one of them has slightly elongated ears. You know, almost a dog-like, but not. They're near human.
Okay. That was good. One of them slips me their number.
Hey, my man!
Let me make that note.
Oh, man, I guess I have to as well.
That's a future contact, my man.
Hey, yo, babe, want to help me break a friend out of prison?
Always the bad boys.
What are you two gentlemen doing?
Waiting for him to come back.
Give me a perception check. 4 difficulty. Okay. Either or both of you.
Yeah, naturally, as it will.
Alright, 3 difficulties?
It all depends on if you're, you know, in the lounge, in the cockpit, in the guns. You know, where are you trying to see this from type of moment, you know?
Well, I think the only place with the windows is the cockpit, right?
Yeah, I say we'd be waiting in the cockpit, probably sitting in the captain and co-captain chair.
Oh, man, you don't know how much I want to say Chaba's fucking around pushing buttons, but I know if I say that, something bad will happen. So
before
I'm not
you roll,
two fails.
Each of
red
you...
die.
I was about to say, before you guys roll, each of you get a red die. But you already rolled, so I'll take that force die point back.
Okay, three, not one advantage. One advantage.
I had two advantage.
You each find a small flask located under each of your chairs.
Oh, nice.
I don't know why you were looking under your chairs when you're trying to keep an eye out for Arden, but that's what you found.
For a minute there, I thought you were going to say a stick of gum.
It'd be ABC Spitz brand.
Ah, oh, gross.
That's why you found a flask.
I don't know. I eat things out of the garbage, so that wouldn't be that bad, I guess.
That's true. That's very true.
By the way, I want to give a blue dye to Arden's next check.
Okay.
Since I had two advantage.
Arden, you want to grab a blue dye?
Yeah, all right.
Bortuna, I need a perception check at 3 difficulty, please.
It's always perception.
Well, you guys are, you know, looking out for things and failing at it.
Yes. That is exactly what is happening.
Why am I not... Hello?
Hello?
I can't, like... There we go, jeez.
Oh, it's probably the lag.
Oh.
Yeah, there's a spike that just happened.
Let me face these just ever so slightly. So they don't get all up in each other's grills.
Oh!
One advantage.
What kind of triumph would you like to do?
I'd like for the main guy that's escorting me to become injured in some way.
As he's
not walking, like grievously,
As he's walking ahead of you, you hear him stumble real quick. Sprained ankle. Can't even walk in the station.
You idiot! Can't even walk right!
I swear, if you don't shut up, they will stun you.
Oh, no.
Arden, could you give me another perception check? 2 difficulty, and this time you're also going to get a second blue boost die.
Oh, God. You're hearing his laughter.
Where the fuck is Bertina coming in to hang out?
Hey!
We just haven't fucking
giant brain.
It's...
You hear Bortuna's laughter. Very distinctly. Even above the clatter of this, you know, group of 4 space groupies, apparently. You look over and you see the Imperial officer kind of walking with a slight limp, and Bortuna is flanked by 2 stormtroopers. But you see him being escorted quite distinctly to the hangar.
Okay. Excuse me, lady. Excuse me, please. Pardon me. I gotta make
a call right fast.
I'm not gonna go far. I'm not gonna go far. I'm just gonna make a call right fast.
Give me an athletics check. It 2 difficulty.
Crawl over the ladies.
I asked for this, but
yes, you did.
I never asked for this. Except you know, I did.
For Grunting Eagles, let's upgrade one of them.
Okay. Oh, no. And they're really strong ladies.
One of them is.
Oh, no.
One advantage.
One advantage?
One advantage.
She's holding on to you in that one place. You know what I'm talking about?
I was going to say, as he's trying to shuffle her off, he cops a feel by accident. But, you know, same difference.
Either way.
There's a blush.
Anime moment.
Rocky. Shaba. I want you to give me a perception check. Same difficulty without the challenge die.
We're going to hear Arden get slapped anime style.
That would seem worse.
Oh.
All he did was move the die over.
Well, I mean, why not? All right. Might as well use one of the light side points we got, because, you know.
Might as well.
Nah, not all of them. Just remembered. It's good, but bad. Isn't this the third triumph we've rolled in this game so far?
Yeah.
Can I get a blue die for someone?
You got the mechanical, but you don't have the success. What type of advantage do you have? Triumphant result do you net from your search?
Well, what am I even looking for here? Am I supposed to be looking out for Arden?
Arden, Fortuna, the shuttle, anything. What do you see? What do thine Jawa eyes see?
That is a good damn question. All right. So Arden is definitely not in this hangar, right?
No. You cannot see him.
Okay, then. I don't know. Maybe. Maybe we see the guys that are transporting Boratuno coming this way. Maybe as a detour, per se, because there's like an accident in the hallway.
You don't see Boratuno. You don't see Boratuno. You don't see Arden.
Okay, then. Find a battery.
You see a stormtrooper fall over.
Oh. I see a stormtrooper fall over and he gets trampled on by like three or four Gamorreans by accident and they're like apologizing over him, but he's clearly dead.
Falling this episode.
He's not dead. There was a minor mishap with the dolly. It was three Gamorreans and they're trying to pick the crap up off the stormtrooper, and the other two stormtroopers that were with the scanning equipment, whom they knocked over, are over there, you know, harassing the Gamorreans while they're picking up, you know, the boxes off of the guy.
Okay. I don't entirely see how this helps us, but okay.
I'm so sorry you don't. That's not my problem, though.
Chabba would probably, like, point and laugh at that and look at Blumbles and point it out.
Yeah. Blumbles look at it and laugh too, and then think, "Wait a minute."
Are we
supposed to give up something?
You are being escorted, Boratuno, right into what looks like the hangar next to the one where the ship was parked. You see a shuttle has landed. The ramp is opening, and there's four additional stormtroopers in that, you know, area right in front of the shuttle.
You guys sure do keep a lot of security. You know that?
Nobody says a damn thing. Yeah, the guy in front of you is walking with a slight limp.
Bunch of stiffs.
Does Boratuno see Arden?
No, he failed that check.
Oh, fuck.
But his laughter at the guy injuring himself alerted Arden to Boratuno.
Yeah, and I tried to like break away to use my comm link, but did I get copped or did I do the cop? I don't know what happened in that situation.
You traded.
Okay.
Boratuno, you were being brought onto the shuttle.
Well, I guess this is it.
I want to try this.
I want to see Dad now. Imperial custody. It's a darn shame.
You're being escorted into his chair?
I like, hey, I'm stuck.
Well, we really can't do anything. We don't even know where anyone is. We're just sitting in the cockpit, just laughing at Imperial.
They're distracted, to say the least.
Yeah.
We don't. We like.
Are you saying this? I know this is how I. You know this. I had a feeling this is how it was going to happen. I had two feelings. It was either going to go horribly, horribly wrong, or like, well, I mean, like, in us shooting up an entire space station and getting arrested because of it, or something like this was going to happen.
Honestly, this is preferable.
As you were sat down, Bortuna, they shuffle your gear off to the side so that you're not sitting directly on it, and they just kind of put you in a jump chair, arms still fastened behind your back, and they kind of put, like, the seat belt over you.
This is apparently not the first time you all have done this.
It seems like there's a couple spots right at the back specifically for a set of hands and binders.
Nobody here is written in the cockpit. You guys just commanded not to talk.
The stormtrooper just kind of tilts his helmet up at you, and you could swear that he's just staring behind the helmet, going, "Oh, why won't you shut up?"
I'm surprised he hasn't been stunned yet.
He hasn't been that boisterous, to be honest. He hasn't fought against them nearly as much as most people would try to. So. Arden.
Yes.
I would say that you can assume that Bortuna has been escorted onto the shuttle at this point.
Please! Let me go!
Well, you win some, you lose some, I guess.
Well, it's like, and then it's like, please, ladies, I have, you know what? Bortuna is fine. I'm just going to enjoy the moment. I'll tell the guys later.
Hey guys, Bortuna's dead, but check out all these groupies.
The most Bortuna thing that's ever happened to me. Is this what it's like? Is this what it's like on the other side?
Oh no.
When you stare at the abyss stares back with hot groupies.
I feel like I've struck a nerve. Come back to my ship.
God. Oh, I'm assuming
Arden tried to call us and we just didn't notice because we were laughing at the Imperial.
Actually, like, Arden hasn't even gone for his comm link. So
I was trying to, but I got, you know, stopped.
No. You said you were heading towards the ship to get their attention. You never, ever mentioned the comm link.
Said I was going to make a call. That's why I was stepping away, but...
Yeah, I do remember.
That works, too. I'm just too distracted by what's going on.
Yeah.
I just never attempted to. That's funnier, though. It's just like, no, wait. I must go. My friends need me.
Hand on crotch. You know what? He doesn't need me that bad.
It's like they don't. They're fine.
He's fine. This is like a Monty Python sketch.
We'll just get him when he goes to Ryloth. Yeah, right.
So, ladies, do you want to come back to the ship for a bit?
Give me a persuasion check. Let's go with one difficulty. They are groupies.
Oh my gosh.
Like. We make this plan, this big old plan with contingencies, and then, like, everything goes wrong, and we're just laughing at Imperials falling over.
I got persuasion.
No, not persuasion. Coercion. No, not coercion. Charm.
Okay. It's all the same.
One
difficulty.
No, oh, please let this work.
Yeah.
You pull a couple of them back to the ship, and once you convince them that you were, you know, heading to your ship, kind of emphasis on the your part, you make your way back towards the ship. You two are watching the Gamorreans have finally picked the stuff up off the stormtroopers, the stormtrooper. The three stormtroopers are flat out just laying into them about, you know, right away and watch where they're going, etc. And give me a perception check, both of you, at 2 difficulty.
Oh boy. Any upgrade?
No, I'm not gonna hurt you guys anymore. Apparently, okay. I don't need to.
Not like really, though. No.
4 success.
I'm fairly certain I have 4 success and three success and an advantage. I'm gonna move the green die.
Nice.
Yeah, so 3 success and an advantage. We see Arden, don't we?
It's not hard to pick up Arden being, you know, escorting a pair of near-human ladies back to the ship. You know, I mean, he's literally got, like, an arm around each of their waists, and he's just bringing them back to the ship.
Chavo would probably just, like, look at Blumbles.
None of those look like Bortuna in a bikini.
He's genuinely confused by this turn of events.
Blumbles gets out of the chair, lets it spin behind him as he goes to wait at the entrance ramp. He's actually going to open the ship if it's already open. I think it already is, yeah.
Yeah, it's open.
Yeah, he's just going to march out of there.
As you were nearing the ship, Arden, you are seeing / smelling. I don't know how you can smell through the helmet, but there you are. The semi-burned form of Blumbles coming out of the ship.
What the hell are you doing?
Well, see, some things happened, and now I've got two beautiful ladies with me. As you can see.
Priorities,
man. Paul just covers his face and pinches his nose.
Is this like the mascot of your ship?
He's a passenger. I'm taking him and one of his little friends to Tatooine.
We're going to Tatooine? Did you hear that? We're going to Tatooine. Yes.
I'm really tempted to have Blumbles do something here, but I'm also wondering if I should ruin Arden's fun or not.
He doesn't get enough of it. That's why Chava stayed on the ship.
Blumbles just gonna cover his head, cover his face palm, rub his brow, go back in the ship, and to see probably Chava standing at the door of the cockpit entrance.
Oh yeah, he you would see him probably making his way to the lounge.
Did you try the flask that you found?
He would probably have it in his hand. I'll, like, open it up. As long as it isn't chloroform. We're talking like a drink flask, right?
Yes.
Yeah, no, actually, yeah, he would just open it and drink it. He doesn't know what's in it, but...
Well, there's no constitution checks. What is the, give me a resilience check. You know, let's go with two difficulty. How resilient is Chaba?
Instantly falls unconscious. Pretty freaking resilient, apparently. Two success.
This is a... It's not weak. It's got a good kick to it. You think it might have been aging itself underneath that seat for a little bit.
Well, that's nice.
It's stronger than the Mandalorian ale you had.
Takes another sip.
Blumbles just goes to... I'm tempted to have him do something.
Rocky is at fault here.
I'm gonna have Blumbles...
Just rolling with it, alright?
They're starting to tug you onto the ship. They're like, taking you by the arms and pulling you onto your own vessel at this point.
Mandalorians. I swear to fuck. Turned out these are Mandalorians in disguise.
They just unzip their faces and there's just Mandalorians underneath.
Jackpot!
Jackpot! Female Mandalorians, alright! I might die, but what a way to go.
Blumbles is gonna go to his room, grab his bowcaster, make sure it's loaded, shoulder it. And he's going to pick up Chaba by the head and put him on his shoulder.
Okay, yep, let's go.
Bortuna.
See?
You're sitting in your chair, strapped in place, but the shuttle hasn't moved yet. It looks like the officer is talking with the pilot, and then he kind of goes and sits in a chair on the other side. Straps himself in. He's like, please, for the love of anything, don't talk this entire trip.
I wouldn't even know what to talk about the whole trip. I mean, I guess I could talk about that one time I tried to apply for the banking plan. Ah, man, you should have seen what a mess I was in. So apparently, you have to have a degree. Can you believe that? Have you seen those jokes? None of them are educated. So anyway, I don't know. I guess I was in my 14th cycle. And I figured you would have interrupted me by this point.
No, I'm letting you go. I'm impressed.
I was in my 14th cycle.
Maybe he's actually interested in banking. You look over
at the Imperial officer and you realize that he's got earplugs in.
Are you the disrespect? Do you know who I am?
The pilot is sitting there though. I don't know. I don't care. Shut up.
And you seem like a nice guy. What's your name?
Honestly, they'll probably just give us more tuna at this point. I'm sorry.
What is Chaba and Blumbles doing? Arden, you've been pulled onto the ship, and you see the armed with both a bowcaster and a Jawa Wookiee.
I'll be like, my ladies, pick a room. Or go in this room over here. I direct them to my room. I'll be in there in a moment. I need to have a chat with my passengers, please.
They go into the room.
All right, there was like... Okay, first off, I'm sorry. Like, literally that... I don't know what happened there. That just kind of happened. I'm just kind of going with it. Let me have this, please. Second, there was like 7 stormtroopers.
He's just staring at him.
And he's already been boarded onto the shuttle. It's most likely getting ready to leave right now. It'd be better if we just went to Ryloth and got him there.
Blumbles would look to Chaba.
Chaba just like...
I would really rather not mess with the Empire. At this point on a station.
You're the one carrying me.
Alright. Chance Cube. What's in your favor, gentlemen?
Well, I'm evil, so red.
Blue, is that go or stay? Blue, Arden gets his way. Red, you get your way. How about that?
I mean, Arden will probably get his way regardless.
No, I won't.
No, I mean, like, at least you don't have to go with us.
You
can just hang out with the ladies for a while we...
Matt Blumbles just looks at him and says, have fun. And then just brushes past him and makes his way off the ship.
Chaba would, like, look at him and give him a thumbs up. Like a, eh.
What are you two doing? Wait, no. Arden, what are you doing now?
What am I doing now?
Does he need to say
The Chaos 2 have left the ship.
The Chaos 2 have left the ship. Well, I could just leave them.
Wait here, I need to go powder my nose.
Do-do-do.
I love how we started this out not doing my idea and we're ending up doing it anyway.
That's because the dice have 100% disagreed with everything.
Yeah. I guess you know what? I'm just going to fuck it, literally. Just go in my room and I'm not going to pay attention at all what's going on until they get back.
All right, roll me a performance check, and we'll get back to you in an hour. You too.
Oh, it is.
All right.
Yes.
Since Blumbles is the pilot of this operation, He's gonna try. He's gonna make his way to Hangar 12. He's gonna like put.
Sorry, I knocked something over.
He's gonna put himself against the wall, like near the corner of the hangar, and he's gonna peek inside and see what he's dealing with.
Give me a stealth check at 3 difficulty because you are carrying a bowcaster and a Jawa in a heavily Imperial occupied facility.
Indeed. Let's see. That's 2 green and 3 difficulty, you said?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Two fails and, 1 threat. So, not good.
As you were at the corner, about to head into Hangar 12, there is a, behind you, hey, stop. What are you doing?
Oh, I thought you were talking to your daughter, so I'm sorry.
Yes, yes, you are my daughter at this point.
What is
it? Blubbles turns around to see who it is.
It's a stormtrooper, weapon drawn, up on you.
He looks up at Chava. Think we should take him?
Okay, so, out of character, I literally was just tempted to say I shoot him in the face.
I know you. I was hoping you'd say that.
You can feel it, right?
Oh, yeah, I could feel it.
I had my own interpretation of this moment and energy, and it wasn't the Jawa shooting the stormtrooper. It was the Jawa leaping on the stormtrooper's face.
Oh, man, if only I was good at melee. Imagine if our dynamic was reversed. You were the ranged guy, and I was the melee guy. Damn.
Oh, yeah, that'd be great.
I'm probably just gonna like.
There's the backup characters, Chumbles and Baba.
If we dies, we die.
All right, Blumbles, are you gonna act or am I?
Well,
give me initiative. Let's go right. For that.
All right, let's initiative again.
Cool.
Yeah, it would definitely be cool in this instance.
Okay, let me see what my cool is. It's 2 green. One success, 1 advantage.
2 advantage. We didn't even make it out of the hangar, man.
You made it to the hangar. You made it to the other hangar.
Oh, we made it there.
You made it to the corner. Okay. Yeah.
Thought we were.
All right. I think I won. Initiative?
Depends on what the stormtrooper rolled.
Oh, yeah, he's going after me. Okay. Now, this is a question for Rocky, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
I'm thinking of... Actually, no, a question for the DM, actually. If I use my bowcaster here, will I have disadvantage or any kind of, like, more purple die?
It's short range.
Yeah, no. It's short range.
Then you won't, I don't think.
Okay.
In fact, you'll actually probably be at a pretty good advantage because you'll only have 1 purple.
Alright. Yeah, Blumbles just turned to look at Chava, then Chava, I guess, would shrug or something. And then Blumbles would unshoulder his bowcaster and shoot the stormtrooper right in the chest.
Alright, let me see if I can find my,
We're going balls deep, boys.
Why?
Does this...
You don't know, you're not there.
This isn't... We're not streaming this, but will this be uploaded anywhere...
It's our normal thing.
Yep.
Okay, hang on. Okay.
He's recording it.
I am recording.
Since we're not streaming, I'm going to do a thing.
Is what's going to... Is it's going to happen, isn't it?
What?
If only he had his lightsaber.
Technically, you do.
Yeah, I do, but it doesn't
just
work.
Not charged.
Earlier, I almost said with that triumph that I find a battery for his lightsaber.
Under the seat.
Yeah.
Under the seat.
There's a lot of stuff under there, apparently.
Okay, so do I roll to hit?
It's your slot. What are you doing?
Yeah, you'd have to roll it.
Okay. Yeah, this is a roll for everybody, because I don't want to just put the party in danger as much as I want to shoot him in the chest. No,
that's not the way this works. If you're taking PC slot one, this is your action. This is what you're doing. What you doing?
If you don't shoot him,
Are you giving it to Chaba?
Okay. If Chaba's going to shoot him, I'll just shoot him anyway. So, pull up my bowcaster, shoot him right in the chest. Two success. And the bowcaster does 10 base damage and has knockdown.
So that's a total of 11 damage. There is the resounding sound of the bowcaster going off. And the stormtrooper flies back, skidding on the ground.
Hey, what are you doing?
Okay. You guys have played Metal Gear.
Yep.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, we've alerted everyone.
Yeah. There's like stormtroopers down the hall. They see the stormtrooper go flying. They see the discharge of the weapon. You see the random civilians that are passed around the area. It's like I said, it's not crowded, but there's people. They start scattering. Bortuna.
What's it?
Perception check, one difficulty, with a boost die.
Bowcasters are not quiet. But yeah, as soon as Rocky said, if you don't shoot him, I'm going to shoot him. I was like, okay, I'll do it.
Yeah.
Two success, one threat.
You are looking out the window as you're chattering on and on, driving everybody around you, except the Imperial officer who's wisely gotten earplugs. You start seeing them kind of sit up in the seat, look out their viewport window, and you can see the stormtroopers that were in the hangar turn their heads, quickly towards the entrance to the hangar and start moving that direction.
Huh. I wonder what's going on. So anyway, after that little stint at the side university, I decided it was time to go to Coruscant and really test my mettle there. Turns out they have the best arithmetic teachers this side of the galaxy. You wouldn't believe it.
Jabba.
So anyway.
Yeah.
What's up?
I'm on top of bubbles.
Yeah, you've seen the stormtrooper go flying.
I would probably look down at Blubbles and say, yeah, we gotta go, right now, my guy.
Yeah.
I'll cover you. Let's go.
Where are we going?
to the shuttle.
Okay. I was like, we're running away.
We're running away. Let's go get Arden.
Yeah, let's go get Arden.
We run towards the danger.
You're going. I am the danger. Blumbles will have to act on the next PC slot, all things considered, let's be honest. But I would say that you kind of turn in your little seat harness and you can look in the hangar and you start seeing four stormtroopers making their way your direction.
Three white knights, no, four white knights stacking up on us.
Pop them if you can.
Can I pop them?
I would say that they're at long range.
I can hit him at long range.
Then I'd say pop one.
Man, this must be the scariest thing these guys have ever seen.
Let's change one of those to a challenge. Because I'm trying to give you guys some light side here.
Yeah.
Understandable.
Hey! Aw.
That's a miss.
But it is a lot of advantages. Yeah. And with those advantages, I'm going to have... What?
They scatter.
Okay. All right. Yeah, that's fine with me.
What would you like for the advantages to do?
The one with the biggest gun, I want it to drop it.
They all have the same gun. A nice... regulation, E11 blaster. Okay. One of them, you got close to it, and he, as he was diving out of the way, he throws the gun, out outside range, basically. As he goes diving behind a box, basically. The other three kind of sidestep off in different directions to try and get away from any possible extra attacks coming their direction. So.
Okay, now I have a question.
You still have one advantage at that, so.
Oh, hot damn. Then I will give a blue die probably to whoever goes next. So with whatever we decide, they get a blue die.
Okay.
Can we see the shuttle from here?
You can.
Okay, I'm just going to shout out, Fortuna! Which I know is going to sound like Utini. But either way, it's going to be, you know.
There is now a Jawa war cry. Blood is in the air and the Jawas are frenzied.
Barbarian rage.
No. Sand rage. Enemy slot. You know what? Let's spin that around. Flip it over. There we go. Still doesn't seem like it's flat, but, you know. Oh, well. I need a drawing tool.
While we're doing that, I'll be back.
The hell? Why am I not able to draw on this all of a sudden? Seriously.
Is it? You might ought to lock it.
What am I, just drawing on the fucking map underneath it?
No, there's a dot there.
Holy crap. Yeah, the dot won't go away. I can't get it to erase for my life.
If I can erase it. Nope. Yeah. I would click erase all lines, but that would also erase literally all the lines, so I just wouldn't worry about it.
Okay. Well, you've got, you know... Shuttle. Hangar doors. Boxing. Actually, no. I want to erase this last one. Give me the erase tool, motherfucker. Thank you. Objects. And because...
I am back.
Welcome back.
Hey, map.
Just to make it kind of easier.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's interesting.
Hmm. Oh, little dots.
If I drop them as... If I have the line tool selected and then drop the pieces, that's what makes those dots. That's why they wouldn't go away.
Weird.
That's good to know. Alright. We have the guys on their turn. That guy has been ducked behind. He's going to start going for his gun. This guy's going to make himself up behind the cover. He's going to move behind the cover. And so it's just going to come straight up on you. And so he... Wow. What the hell is... Go away. The text thing's just, like, huge, and I can't get it to go away now. There we go. This guy will fire at you. So.
Okay.
Which one of us?
Blumbles, because he is the biggest target, let's be honest.
Oh, yeah.
And it was, he moved up, so it's going to be medium range now. Do you have any black dice for defense or anything, Blumbles?
I don't know if I do with my padded armor. Let me see. No, I don't have any black dye.
On the bright side, though, it did add to your soak value, I think.
Oh, yeah, I have 6 now.
By the way, I flipped another coin. He is upgrading one of his dice.
Okay.
Well. That did not help him much. All he got in the roll was 2 advantage.
Okay.
He is going to add a black die to the next character's check.
Okay.
So whoever goes next, include a black die. So if he takes a shot, it goes a little bit wide. And it looks like they're, you know, getting ready for, you know, a counterattack on the guys on the side. They are still at long range. Yeah.
So, should we move or kill them? Well, we can do both, right? Move and kill them?
You know, one person gets a turn at a time, so.
That's what I mean.
It takes me a maneuver to cock my, my thing. Yeah, cock my bowcaster.
Just remember, you're at the door like that.
Oh, okay, good. I thought we were standing right in the middle. That's good.
What do you think we should do? Want me to shoot, or?
I'm thinking of having you shoot, maybe hitting this guy, and if you take him out, that'd be great. But after that, I'm planning on having Blumbles maybe move right here to at least give us get us a little closer and have some cover. I know we'd be right where this guy is. But yeah, at least then I'd have my gun cocked and I'd make my way over there.
Okay. Should I stay here or should I go with you?
Probably best to go with me.
Okay.
Stay in the harness, it says.
Are there door controls right where we are right here? Hangar door controls, or do these use ray shields on the inside?
No, they're physical doors, but no, they are not on your side unless you want to spend some force points.
Okay, so I guess instead I'm just going to shoot this guy.
Okay.
What's the range for him?
Medium now.
Okay, then that would be 2 purple, and I have a custom grip on my gun, so that black die is negated.
Nice.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Are you fucking kidding me? Again with this? Alright. That's fucking annoying.
Don't forget light side.
I moved that. And, I'll just use the light side to reroll the positives. Might as well, because it's fucking important here.
You think?
Yeah.
Oh my god! Two triumphs and 1 threat. Is this the real life?
I'm taking a screenshot of that.
That's insane.
That's beautiful.
Is that legal?
In our game, it is.
If I would have rolled a third one, I'd go directly to jail.
All right. What is the damage on your weapon, sir?
9. No, 8. It's 8.
So it's 8 plus 2. Because the amount of advantages you got. What do you want to do with some advantages?
Okay. I don't think I... alright, so hang on. Well, I'm not sure, but I'm fairly certain I probably killed that guy.
Oh yeah, he did.
But do I have 2 mechanical triumphs here? How does this work?
Yeah, I mean, in combat, triumphs can be used to, when dealing damage to a target, have the attack destroy a piece of equipment they're using, upgrade the difficulty of the targeted character's next, you know, yada 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 yada. Do something vital, such as shooting controls in the nearby blast doors, seal them shut, you know.
Okay, so.
Ow.
So we're standing in like a hallway, right?
Yeah, at the entranceway of the hangar itself.
I want to look at the shuttle in front of me, and I see like the hydraulics that would close the ramp and all that shit. Do I know that those have like a manual thing where they, like, if they're damaged, there's a way to manually close the door?
I'm going to allow you to do this because of the triumphs. Give me a knowledge technology. I mean, what lore? What's the closest thing?
Probably. Oh, there is no technology, is there? Well, it could be a mechanics check. Theoretically.
Yeah, let's go with a mechanics check. Let's see how much you know about the shuttle.
What difficulty?
One difficulty. It's Triumph. I'll make that easy.
Alright, that's 3 success and 1 advantage.
You would know that if one of the hydraulics was hit, they would have to make a repair to it before they could close that door properly.
Nice.
You are not 100% sure if there's not an emergency procedure in place for something like that or not. You don't know that shuttle specifically.
Okay. So, with my triumphs, is it possible that I could damage that in some way?
I would say that your shot would, you know, carry past the stormtrooper and hits the left side's strut control.
Nice.
Not controller. The strut itself. You, like, gouge some of it out with that shot.
Okay. Was that both of my triumphs, or would that just be one of them?
Let's go with both.
Okay. All right.
Well, you know, one to have the knowledge check, one to actually make the successful damage.
Okay. All right.
You know, that actually would fit, because 2 triumphs, when dealing damage to a target, have the attack destroy a piece of equipment they are using.
Well, they weren't using it, technically, but still.
Technically.
This guy is still scrambling for his weapon. I'd say he gets to it. This guy has a line of shot on you, Blumbles. He is going to take that shot.
Okay, quick question. Are they lethal or non-lethal? Are they trying to stun or hurt?
Probably lethal. So far, what you've seen, I would say lethal. I'd say that they're red bolts.
Okay, I'm actually comfortable with that. I prefer them to damage my health rather than my strength.
Wow, really? I don't know if you're going to like that here in a second.
Oh boy, they got a triumph, didn't they?
No.
Okay.
12 damage.
Ooh, okay. I'm out of 6 from that, so...
6.
I'm going to say I have piercing.
No piercing.
Okay, I'm down to 14. Or 13. Yeah.
That is a squarely solid shot. However, because of the way he had to lean out from behind the cover to make said shot, he did expose himself. He has a blue die against him.
Okay.
So anybody that shoots at that particular gets a blue die.
Okay.
I'll put it with him so that it, you know, it signifies there.
All right. Okay. Blumbles, you get 2 maneuvers, right?
1 maneuver, 1 action, 1 free.
Okay,
you can sacrifice your action to get 2 maneuvers.
Okay.
You can also sacrifice some strain to get an extra maneuver, can't you?
Yes, you can.
Okay.
For 2 strain.
Alright, what I think I'll do is I'll have Blumbles. Moving's like just a maneuver, right?
I think moving is a maneuver. Depends on, you can move 1 range band.
1 range band.
Okay, so what would the range band be from here to here?
Well, probably, depends on who you're looking at. That guy's medium, so it'd probably be from, medium to short. This guy, I think, is long, so it'd be moving from, long to maybe medium? I don't know. Will this guy be, this guy, is he long or extreme to us?
He's long. And this guy would. I'm also going to say that this guy is long. I would say to get behind that pack of cover, it would be 2 maneuvers.
Okay, so I think I'll suffer some strain to give me another maneuver. So what is that? Just 1 strain or 2 strain?
2 strain.
Okay, I'm down to 8 strain. So I'm going to have Blumbles move here with Chava in tow. Preferably.
Unfortunately, yes. I'm going to say add an extra strain because you're hauling him as well.
Okay. And, let's see. That's my 2 maneuvers that I got. I think I'll just have Blumbles use his action as his maneuver to cock his bowcaster. And then I'll have Chava. I'll like lean out, be close enough to right here, like on the edge of this here, mm-hmm. so Chava could get a shot off at this guy.
Okay.
Like he's got his back against it, and his left shoulder is like facing this way, and Chava's like aiming out, I guess.
Sure.
Okay, that's what Lumples does.
This guy has grabbed his gun, and he's going to move up here. This guy is going to move around. He's now in open. He's not, you know, in any type of secluded area. He's just flat out in the open, and he's going to take a shot at Chava. And he's going to add a black die simply because, you know, he's on the Wookiee.
Yeah.
He will also get a blue die tacked onto his next targeted attack to him. Chava. That's 11 damage.
Oh, okay. I am not dead. But that really hurt.
Oh.
Like, really, really bad.
Oh. Oh, what are you at?
I mean,
I have 1 hit point.
Oh no. Okay.
PC slot.
Shoot him or him?
I choose the one that's got a great shot on you, but that's just me.
I agree. Yeah. Are you in agreement with that? As well.
I am in agreement of shooting this guy, yes.
Okay, that's 2 blue die on that guy.
Fortuna, could you give me a perception check? 2 difficulty.
Wow. Yeah, I think you should space your... I think you should space your dice out.
All my luck on that fucking 2 triumphs. Alright, there was no way I could possibly roll worse than that.
Oh, so yeah.
That's 3 success and 1 advantage.
Did you take the blue die that was added
for you? Yeah, I took the blue die too, yeah.
Okay.
This one landed
first. Did your dice land like that?
I don't know.
Because he groups them really tightly together.
Yeah, which it doesn't really... It doesn't normally cause any issues. They usually roll straight up and then land straight down.
No, Cody's.
What the hell?
It's cockeyed on nothing.
Yay! Success!
And to advantage. You're seeing the storm, the firefight out the front view screen. And you're seeing like the blaster bolts going everywhere. And you think you just saw the Wookiee and the Jawa duck behind a box.
And so anyway, that was how I tried to apply for the Banking Clan. And didn't get accepted because I tried to get into plumbing instead. So, what'd you think of the story?
Didn't the ship they were in just get shot too?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Where are my belongings in relation to me again?
To your left side.
And my hands are secured behind my back.
I'm still in binders, and you are seat belted into the chair.
Gotcha. So, no way of me finagling myself out of this particular position unnoticed.
Unnoticed? Probably not. But you can still try to finagle yourself out if you chose.
Okay.
Battle of the Fates playing for you guys?
It was.
Let's try to finagle myself out while I begin another whimsical tale from my youth. I remember this time I visited Tatooine with Mom. Oh my gosh. Have you guys seen Jawas in real life?
Remember, the guy has earplugs in.
At least he can't hear it.
The pilot is like fucking, you know, checking a whole bunch of shit, watching the firefight outside, like, could we get some help in Hangar 12? There seems to be some sort of shit going on outside. give me a skullduggery. And let's say at 3 difficulty. To attempt to wrangle yourself out of the seat harness.
Can I give him a blue die? I have 2 advantages.
He's got blue.
Alright, lads, here we go. Let me double check my skullduggery. It should be 2 yellow. It is.
Oh boy, here we go.
Yes! 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 Yes!
Wow. This has been the most triumphs we've ever rolled in a game.
Yes!
And when they matter, they fucking work.
As you were talking this story, you're finagling yourself. You kind of turned in the seat, and you've gotten your arms out of the little pocket, and you hit the little button to release the strap. Nobody has noticed.
And so Mom thinks, you know what? We need to go watch a pod race. I'm still in the binders, though, right?
Yes.
Still behind my back?
Yes.
Can I try to, like, I don't know, am I double jointed? Can I pull my arms over my head?
It might be easier to pull your arms over your butt.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Serious. Let me do that.
Give me an... Athletics seems wrong, but I think that okay.
I think there was a thing for it. Is it coordination?
It's probably coordination.
No, maybe.
I think I read it. I think I read it in the book that it was like coordination for something. Like, let me open it up right fast.
Oh, I think the physicals are going for a lot of money.
The mess we're in is unreal. Just saying.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's bad. It's very bad.
Characters can use coordination to escape from restraints, contorting their limbs at unusual angles so that bindings slip free.
So it's literally what we're looking for.
Yeah.
Okay. Next.
What kind of difficulty am I looking at?
Let's say a 3 difficulty, because honestly, you're not used to this. Let's be honest.
No, no, not even a little bit. It's gonna take a miracle. I get a blue die?
I am impressed.
Yes!
Wow.
Woo!
You take a point of strain. But you have, you know, kind of turned yourself in the seat, grabbed the bottom edge of the seat with your hands, pulled yourself up, you know, as you're talking to the fucking pilot nonstop. You kind of hurt yourself doing it, but you finally get your hands as tightly bound as they, you know, are in the metal binders past your ass so you can slip them down behind your legs and pull them out in front of you.
And Mom said, let's go watch a pod race. And I said, Oh God, this is gonna chafe, because the seats, because the seat were really uncomfortable, it was gonna chafe. I have very sensitive skin, you see. Reach into my bag.
Hang on,
Harry. What? What?
Uh oh.
What's going on?
As you're talking and you're making the grunting sounds because of the pain and everything, the pilot looks behind him. As he's calling for help, and he's, what the, he noticed the tonal change. He looks behind himself, and he sees you, hands in front of you.
Oh, he was listening. How respectful.
Hi.
Well, I thrust my hands down into the bag, and I pull out a small spherical object, and a little blue smiley face painted on. I place my finger on a black switch located on the back of the device and sweetly whisper, Gary, I'm so sorry.
This is what I was made for.
I'm getting off this ship and you're gonna let me.
He kind of stands up in his chair and pulls out a small hold-up blaster. You're not going anywhere.
My finger comes off this trigger buster, We're all going to Tatooine.
Your hands are still in the bag.
Oh, right. I lift them up out of the bag. I said I pull out a small spherical device.
He did say that.
I apologize on that. I think this made it even funnier, though.
I agree. I now...
I have conditioner!
you pull out a baseball. No. You lift your hands out of the bag, and you're, like, cupping Gary, and your finger's, like, on the dead man switch. And he's got his gun on you. He looks in your hand. Now I'm rolling for intelligence.
Oh, no! Please be smart!
With two advantage, he knows that you've got something dangerous. He's just not 100% sure what. Is it a thermal detonator? Is it a stun grenade? Is it a baseball you're going to chuck at his head? He's not 100% sure. He kind of, like, he doesn't drop the gun, but he does, like, lower it a bit while keeping it aimed at you. Instead of, like, straight-armed, he kind of, like, drops his elbow down. He's unsure of what to do at this moment.
I'm going to need you to get me safely in one piece off of this vessel. And if my finger comes off this trigger, we are going to die.
I'm doing a perception check real quick. Does Numbnuts with the earplugs notice what's going on?
He's probably falling asleep.
Isn't he sitting right next to Bortuna?
Yes.
In front of him, isn't he?
Next to him.
No. He's doing everything he can to not pay attention to me.
That's a good point. But it didn't work. He's like looking at the pilot, seeing his stance, looks over at you. Let's see if he knows what that is.
He doesn't know what that is. The Empire's in trouble.
Once again, Metal Gear alert.
He quickly and promptly pulls the earplugs out, stands up, and pulls his own weapon on you, Portoon, and says, "The fucking fool's got a thermal detonator!" The pilot looks at him, looks at you, looks at the device, puts his arm back straight. Chaba.
Yes.
Bumbles, this is your turn.
Yes. Okay, do you want me to take this, Rocky, and take you off my shoulder and put you right here? And then I take a shot, or what?
I never got my movement action earlier, actually. I was actually going to say that I just kind of slide off of Blumbles and kind of sit down behind the crate, because I got pretty fucking heavily wounded from that shot. But if I can't do that, do what you must.
Okay.
We have to save Bortuna.
Yep. Okay.
You're very conflicted right now, Blumbles. The man you've owed a life debt to is pretty fucked up. But he's given you a direct order to save the Twi'lek.
Okay. Bumbles looks at him and looks to the shuttle. And he's going to just sigh and take Chaba off his shoulder with his free hand, place him down right there, and say, "Just stay down.
I'll cover you. Fuck that."
And then Blumbles is going to pull himself out a little bit of cover and shoot at this fellow.
Okay.
And I'm on Rocky's side. And get the blue die. Difficulty?
It is long range, so it would be 3 shot.
Okay. It's a good thing I got that. I'm actually going to space my dice out a little bit more.
That's why I'm pulling the other ones away from your rolling area.
Thank you. Okay, wow. That is improbable. I'm going to re-roll that, because screw that. That is ridiculous. I need at least one. 2 success.
Are you serious?
Oh. Technically, it's better.
Yeah, technically.
Okay, let me look at the advantages I got. I'll give a blue die, too, huh?
Don't you have, like, no advantages, though?
Never mind. 3
disadvantage. As you go to take your shot, you slip in a puddle of something on the floor.
Chaba blood.
On your side. On your
Oh.
It's not a banana peel, it's Stormtrooper blood. Let's go with that.
One of the above.
This one is going to shoot at you. It is long range, so it's 3 difficulty. We've got to upgrade one of them because you're on the ground. And I am going to upgrade one of his.
That doesn't sound like a good laugh.
Oh, he misses badly. he misses very, very badly, but he got a good amount of advantage. He has shot the bowcaster over here.
Well, dang it.
So I'm not the only one that happens to. Wait, what? Blumble's upside... Oh, right, he fell over.
He's on his, yeah. He's on his ass, basically. It's just the best way I could represent it. PC slot. I think it would be Chaba's turn.
You want me to shoot a guy? Or you want to take him and get up and do something?
Honestly, I'd rather you stay in cover because you've got 1 HP.
I mean, I am in cover and I'm at long range. I technically have the advantage here because I have 3 yellow and 1 blue. Even if I shoot at them, even if, you know, they're behind cover, I still negate their black die.
Okay.
But, you know, you're prone next to a crate.
Yeah.
I won't die even if I get, you know, well, I probably won't die. Even if I get shot again, unless I get, like, completely bone-nailed. But then again, I bone-nailed that Mandalorian, and he lived, so.
I do have a suggestion.
What's that?
Maybe see if the door controls are on this side, because I'd say there may be reinforcements coming.
Are the door controls on this side, Cypress? That I can see. Oh, fuck, they're over there. Damn it.
Well, I gave you the option of burning a force point earlier to put them on your side.
The problem is, if we close the doors, then we're stuck in here, too.
Yep.
Yeah.
And I think there's stormtroopers in the ship as well, right?
I think there's just 2.
I know there's the officer and the pilot, right? Well, I mean, can't we see inside there now? I shot, like, some of the hydraulic lift.
You could burn your action to give me a perception check.
Nah, I mean, I'm shoot a guy, I guess. Or should I? What do you think I should do? Or should I do anything? We're here to get Bortuna, but I'm not sure how that's going.
I'm really conflicted.
You're a little woozy from blood loss, so that makes sense.
Yeah, I was going to say.
I'm just saying, if we're going to shoot a guy, I feel like I'm our best option for shooting a guy.
I say if you shoot a guy, you could, like, position yourself right here over top Blumble's, like, after this guy shot and missed wildly, you just, like, come over here and just psh, this guy.
Alright.
That's my suggestion.
I'll, like, kind of lean over the crate, set my, like, rifle on top of Blumble's back, and, like, fucking fire at the guy. Long range, right?
Long range. You did move, right, in order to get there?
I didn't really move. I kind of just leaned over.
Well, you're got the boxes in the way.
Well, wait, if I just stay behind the box, can I aim with my maneuver?
But then you couldn't see over the boxes.
Am I that short?
Yes! You're a Jawa.
Oh, well, then, yeah. I mean, there's really not much of a difference if I aim or not. I just gain another blue die, I think.
But you can't hit anything from there.
I can hit something from here, right?
So you would.
That's what
move.
I'm saying. That's what. Yeah, I move. Yeah.
Okay, but then you couldn't aim because aiming takes a maneuver action.
Well, I don't need to aim. I already get another. I already get a blue die just for my.
All right.
And we'll roll the check.
3 difficulty.
Okay. Right, so, two success, one threat.
Kapow! There that stormtrooper goes, right on the deck. Enemy slot. Fortuna.
Yep.
At the inside of the ship, you hear the officer yelling at the pilot, "Get us out of here! I can't close the ramp. I've been trying."
No. If I let my finger off this switch, mister, we die. If you close that ramp, finger is coming off.
Is this a coercion or a deception?
Do you really mean it?
The best part? It doesn't matter. Interpret it how you want.
And mechanically, it doesn't matter. I understand, but
my resolution has steeled. This is coercion.
Let's go with two difficulty. Upgrade one of them to a red.
Yay, we got two light side now.
Okay. Come in here.
Oh boy, make or break here.
Wait. There is a thermal detonator in play.
Okay. That's good.
That's a success and one threat.
This is very mentally taxing. Let's be honest. You're standing there. You've got this thermal detonator cupped in your hands, finger on the switch. You get me off the ship, or I'm going to let go. And the guy believes you.
You see this thing? Yeah, you know what this is.
Oh. Are you going to move?
So what's it
going
to be then, boys?
Are you going to move, or are you going to stay put and hope that they cooperate with you at this point? What are you going to do?
Escort me off this ship. Wait, I know the relative position of Blumbles and Chaba, right?
You have a rough idea.
Okay. Then I know where I'm going.
Okay. So
come on, boys. Let's go.
You're going to take your maneuver. Let's put you here on the deck. Let's get a couple of other pawns here for pilot and you know what? I don't like this. Let's give him. Let's make him purple.
Now, I just had an idea.
Yeah. So you want them to come with you?
They're going to escort me. They are my meat shields.
Well, your coercion did pass. So we're going to move you back out of the cockpit. And now you're in the general hold section. You know, where the ramp is, you know, able to be, you know, followed down type moment. You're keeping your eye on them. They're keeping an eye on you. Their weapons have not gone away. And you're still holding said thermal detonator.
Gary, if you will.
You're holding the thermal detonator. Give me a perception check with one difficulty, please.
Yes, sir.
Ooh, boy.
That is three success, one threat.
You're going to pick up a black die for your next check. instead of giving you constant strain.
Okay.
As you step back into this area, it is empty. The two stormtroopers that were escorting you are now at the bottom of the ramp in the hangar area, and you can see them. You know, these two. Enemy slot. This guy's going to go around and take a quick shot. Long range.
Who are we hitting?
He's going to go after you because you're on the ground.
Okay, good.
Thirteen damage before soak.
Ooh, okay. Let's see, it's a total of...
Seven.
Seven damage? Okay. Down to six wounds.
That's good. Let's go with PC slot number three.
Alright, so, what do we do here? Take out that guy? Or...
You only know of that guy. The boxes are blocking your view of the other two that have stepped off the ramp. You don't know about them yet.
Okay, so... when I Blumbles look over at his bowcaster, does it look like damaged, or is it just like scuffed?
They knocked it away from you.
Okay. I was gonna have him look over it, but... I think if it's complicated, because if I take an action to get it and then come back, I'll suffer two strain to use two maneuvers to get it. Then I'll use my action to cock it. I'll probably move to the same position.
Wasn't it already cocked?
Oh yeah, it was already cocked. Okay. So yeah, I'd have to use... I think it's a maneuver to get up, right?
Yes.
Okay, so I'd suffer two strain, get that. I'd have to take three maneuvers, actually, to get right back here, but I'd just grab it, shoot him. That'd solve one problem.
Maneuver to get up, maneuver to get it, maneuver to move back.
Okay. What do you think I should do, Rocky?
So you could go and get it, but then you couldn't move, so you would have to shoot at him.
I would have to shoot. That's what I'm thinking of doing.
He's already at long range, and he's at long range regardless. Do you think you can hit him? That's
I think the bowcaster's medium.
Let me see. Actually, I think it tells on the card here. Does it?
It's supposed to.
Ranged heavy, medium. Yeah. So I'd have a extra dive difficulty, I think.
I don't know.
Your range would not allow you to.
You can't hit beyond your max range, unfortunately. Apparently.
Okay.
I thought I had stim packs on me, but I think I used them earlier when we got attacked by those motherfucking Mandalorians.
I think so.
You don't have a stim pack, do you?
Nope. I have two. It's comlinks.
You want me to shoot him? Or do you want to give Bortuna this? Or is Bortuna like on his own thing?
He's a PC slot. We have three PC slots now.
And we're on slot three.
Okay, what I'm thinking... if I say what I'm thinking, I'll be basically giving Cody orders on what to do, and I don't want to do that. I don't want to do that.
You can always suggest.
Yeah. Okay, I guess I'll suggest this to Cody, if I give it to Cody. Bortuna could yell out, "I got a fucking bomb up here!" Those two guys will roll around and go, "Oh, you got a bomb!" I don't know. I don't know if that'd work or not. Maybe these guys are too stupid. Or maybe the guy's escorting you'll be like, "Yeah, he's got a thermal detonator, you idiots."
I can just make I can attempt to make the commanding officer tell his troops to stand down because there's a bomb threat.
Okay, should we take that risk, Rocky?
Well, there's always a lot of... It's complicated. I won't say that I know I can hit this guy. But if I take a maneuver to aim, I'll have two blue die on my roll to hit the guy. And if he's dead, that completely removes the variable of him being able to shoot us. But and if he does shoot us, either of us will go down in one more shot, probably.
Yeah, so and honestly, yeah, I think you should just go for the shot.
Yeah, just kill the guy.
Alright.
We got light side if we need him.
So I will maneuver aim. Need another blue die. And three difficulty, right?
Yes, sir.
I don't know if I'd line him up like that.
Don't worry, it always works out. See?
Okay, it did.
There's another triumph. Why I do that. Yeah, another triumph. And that would be three success and one threat. And a triumph.
No.
Two success. Yeah, no. Three success. And that's just it. Yeah, I didn't see the. I didn't see that one. Sorry. Heat of the moment.
That's all right. So three success, which is more than enough to eliminate him. What can your triumph do?
Okay. Can my triumph in some way perhaps hit some sort of important electrical machinery over here that could possibly provide us with some sort of cover in this like general area? Like, not like physical cover, but like maybe the lights go out so that they can't see us as well or something.
As the stormtrooper falls to his death from being shot by Chaba, the gun, you know, kind of falls back behind him, you know, hands still on it, hits the ground, figure hits the trigger just right, and a stray shot goes off into the hangar. And all of a sudden the lights go down. There's still plenty of light coming in from the hallway. Let's change the color.
I love that Imperial March thing. It's so good.
You know, there's still light coming in.
Yeah.
But now the hangar, for the most part, is, you know, switching over to that emergency red lighting.
All right.
Nice job.
Enemy slots. Sorry, I'm having to look up stormtrooper armor all of a sudden. I don't know why. Seems kind of important in this moment about what they can and can't do. Okay then. I think it's classified as laminate armor. Yeah, that's what I thought. Okay. PC slot one.
Okay. What now? Should I go get my gun and then take cover or what?
I don't know. I'm effectively at this point. I mean, I'm effectively, you know, we don't know those guys are there. I don't think, right?
I don't know. You think don't. So
Chaba doesn't know they're there, so he's effectively out of this equation.
Okay. Sake. So, should we give it to Bortuna?
If we do, and Bortuna manages to get himself escorted out of there, then as we're leaving, you could grab it if necessary. I mean, obviously, yeah. It's necessary. You're not going to leave it there. But,
no.
But if stormtroopers come in first into the room from that side, they may not see it, and they could kick it towards you. That's very unlikely. It's a possibility. I'm only pointing it out because of that. They also might just be all like, yoink. So, yeah. And it's also, it's where that black dot is, right?
It's where the black pawn is.
Then, yeah, I'd get it.
Okay, actually, what I think I'll do, I technically have 3 maneuvers if I give up my action, right?
Yes.
Excuse okay. Me.
Sorry, mid-yawn. Yes, no, you can't take more than 2 maneuvers in the turn.
Ah, dang it.
Well, you can still run, grab it, and come back, right?
He could run and grab it. Because he has to get up.
Oh, right, he's prone. Fuck, I keep forgetting about that.
Yeah, I'm prone. That's the problem. If I run up and get it, that may actually be fine, because I'll still be behind cover.
Yeah, they can't see us back here.
Yeah. Although
the further they move in, the more danger they put themselves in too.
Yeah, they could maneuver around here though. They could, like next enemy action, they could just split up and pincer maneuver us and then hit us. Although I'm probably giving Cypress ideas. I don't know if that's what he intended.
Another thing though, if we give this to Cody and he manages to get them to stand down now, we won't have to worry about that.
Yeah.
But if he doesn't, then we will
bad time.
Definitely bad time.
You know what? Fortune favors the bold. I say give it to Cody.
Should have pizzaed when you French fried.
All right, here's what's going to happen when we start walking down that ramp, bozos. You there with the... Does the commanding officer have a funny looking hat on?
Just that normal little, gray job.
Okay. All right, hat boy. You're going to tell every troop that's in this hangar to stand down and stop firing because there's a bomb threat. Capiche? Capiche?
Frankly, once you step away from the shuttle, they are going to gun you down.
That's why you're going to stand in front of me.
He kind of gives you a puzzled look like, why would I do that? What are you going to do? Are you going to attempt to grab him, half strangle him, kind of a thing, and make him a human shield / bomb vest? That won't work with the thermal detonator.
He could wrap his arms around him, while he's handcuffed, wrap his arms around him that way.
I mean, I don't think what he thinks he can do in this situation, because, if I let my finger off the trigger, he's dead. Like, this is it. Like, he has zero power in this situation. Like, if anything happens to me, he dies. Because I'm just going to spend all my time... he's my leverage, basically.
And that's why I made the statement earlier that Grand Admiral Thrawn would only be as smart as I am.
Fair. Well, the reason I believe that you're going to help me do this, sir, is because if my finger comes off this trigger, you are going to die, and that is the end of the story. If anything happens to me, if I get shot, if I feel a little sweat on my fingers and I just can't seem to hold on to it because I'm just a little nervous with all these guys pointing their guns all over the place, then you're gonna get blown to Kingdom Come!
Yeah, you fucking tell him. Oh, my chest hurts.
You are free to leave the ship anytime you want, Nawara Bortuna.
Sorry about getting blood on you there, Mumbles.
Wait, what do you say?
I said you're free to leave the ship anytime you want, Nawara Bortuna.
Okay, but you're coming with me.
No, I don't think I will. You're either going to blow me up, or you won't. At this point in time, you're going to die one way or the other.
Well, then I guess I'll just have to take you with me then, won't I? Come here, buddy.
Give me a... I don't think there's a grapple, so we're going to have to go with brawl? Are there grapple rules in this game?
I think there are, but they do involve brawl.
Grappling, page 218. Your hands need to be free. No.
For some reason, I actually have a point in Brawl. I have no idea why.
Basic Brawl attack allows characters to deal damage to target's strain threshold and to knock the target prone, disorient. Basically, that is the rule of grappling. Is give me a Brawl check.
Use that muscle.
We're going to go with a 2 difficulty. Because I don't see this man trained in Brawl either.
Ha, what a whip.
Wait.
You only have...
Yeah, I only have the one. Well, here we go.
Come on, light side work. Huh.
How anticlimactic.
You have light side?
Think yeah. I should? I mean, nothing bad can happen, right?
At this moment, no. Nothing bad could happen.
Like a slap fight with a thermal nuclear warhead clutched in your hand.
White side point, I'm going to...
Just the green.
Yep.
Honestly, if you roll better than this, it's good either way. Oh, come on!
It's not meant to be. The force wills it. As you kind of, you know, lunge towards him, you're trying to wrap your arms around him, kind of a thing, and he's like, stop, and flailing around, kind of a thing, and, you know, doesn't dislodge Gary from your grip, but you cannot get your arms around him either.
This is just awkward for everybody now.
Fuck, hang on, I got to mute, dying. Okay, I'm done dying.
Okay. No, you're not.
Yeah, no. Yeah.
PC slot 2, because I'm moving the stormtroopers. The pilot is still standing there, kind of dumbfounded. You know, the Imperial officer would just slap fighting it out with Bortuna.
Mm-hmm. Should I do it?
Do it.
All right. Well, I'm just gonna use maneuver to get up, and he's gonna. Let's see, how am I going to use 2 maneuvers, though? I think I'll just have to burn my action?
You burn the action as a maneuver.
Okay.
Or you can spend the extra strain to get that extra maneuver to get that extra action.
Okay, so if I do that, well, I'll be able to get up, go over, grab it, come back. Probably not.
No, because that would be 3 maneuvers.
Okay. So,
As it stands, I'm not even having you burn an action to grab the bowcaster.
Okay, so I think I'll just burn my action to go over and pick it up.
Grab your gun.
Yep. I'm still behind cover, kinda, but yeah, we'll see what happens. not good.
Not that bad, though, either.
Red or blue? You guys pick a color each.
Blue.
Does that mean he shoots me, or... Yep. What? Did he say yep, or...
Yep.
Nope. Okay. Well, at least I'm behind cover.
Well, there's this guy here.
That's
the guy that's firing at you. 3 green, 2 purple. Fucker still misses.
Oh, God. This is worse than, like, the dock fight.
The shot comes very close, though. I mean, it's just... It, like, hits at your feet.
Oh, God.
PC slot 3.
Yeah, okay, I'm going to shoot that guy. Is that right? There, right?
Go ahead.
Okay. What range is that?
Medium. 2 difficulty.
Aim. Fire it, motherfucker.
Wait, why do you have two blue?
I am aiming, and I have that's
some grip.
Yep, I'll take it. Literally no fails. So nice. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 success and one advantage.
Pretty sure he's just gone.
Yeah, just a nice big hole right in the chest, right where the heart should be.
Wow, this guy's determined. All right. I saw his friend get atomized. He's like, yeah, I'll do this. I'll do it, man.
He is going to stay at the medium range, though. But he is going to upgrade one of his dice.
Which one's he shooting at now? Maybe
Lumbles. Okay. Either way, if he hits, I'm probably down. If he does more than 12 damage. Yeah, more than 11, actually.
10 damage.
Oh,
success.
Okay.
Are you at one hit point as well?
Let's see. 10 minus 6, that's 4, so I'm down to 2 hit points.
Okay.
Woo!
You shoot him, we shoot him.
PC slot 1.
Miryu, my goldman, which one?
You are a better shot, I'm gonna let you take it.
Okay, is he at medium range?
Yes, but you're going to have to kind of step out from the cover. I would say that he's, you know.
Well, if he's at medium, can I just move into short to shoot at him?
Sure.
Well, then I'll do that.
It seems like a really bad pun, though.
It's worth it. Anything I should... Oh, regular, okay.
This little nice. Bloodied Jawa just steps out from behind the boxes and you just bam.
Freaking annihilated. Nice shot, Jawa.
Thanks. All right, let's fucking get in there. We're going to have to take a hostage, I'm pretty sure.
Your brawl is 1. Bortuna.
It is.
He's trying to wrestle the thermal detonator out of your hand right now.
Is he insane?
A little bit. He
might get
blown up. He ain't got much to lose right now. Oh, shit. I took the purple die out of my roll instead of a green.
I had no difficulty for obvious reasons.
He grabs the thermal detonator from your hand, kind of slides your finger off of the dead man switch as he puts his own finger there,
uh-huh.
And he wrestles it from your grip.
What an idiot! This is the best thing that could happen to me! I flew towards my comrades!
It is PC slot 2 now.
I'm running!
I'm gonna give that to Bortuna.
Yeah.
That's as far as you can make it on a maneuver.
What?
Well, I mean, you can always burn 2 strain to get enough.
No, he could just burn his action.
And burn your
action. I was gonna say, he could just burn his action.
Double run! Just
keep running.
Hating the Joestar secret technique.
Yes.
Passed down through the Korvowitz family line for generations.
Buddy!
He's running at you, hands bound together. Oh god, you actually shout that?
What did he say?
Give me a perception check. Let's go with 2 difficulty.
Is this... this isn't a player action, right?
No.
Okay. Oh, wait, I can't copy things.
Wow.
What?
What? Sorry, I got blood in my ears.
Enemy slot.
How does this thing work?
How did you know?
Oh.
I'm flipping one of your light sides.
Oh, did it actually blow up?
I'm giving him a check on it.
Okay.
Oh, I will be honest. That's actually not what I wanted to happen.
He said it's
too late, I guess. Anyway. Yeah.
I think it was going to happen the moment he had the grenade in his possession.
Oh, yeah, totally.
So,
Da-da-da-da-da.
Cody?
Uh-huh?
You have their phone number, right?
Whose?
Theirs.
Who's theirs?
All of them.
Like, the guys?
Yeah.
I mean, like, I can get in touch with them via Discord.
Seriously, you guys hang out with each other's houses and you don't have each other's phone numbers.
My cell phone don't work here.
And I don't have a cell phone in Sarah.
I have John's.
Well, I'm sending you the picture first because I've now got to connect my phone to my computer.
Oh boy, we're going to see what they rolled.
Wait, can't I just put it in Discord?
I think he has to do it via text message to you first or something.
Well, I was hoping he'd be able to send it to you guys directly rather than have to go through this process.
Hold on. I'm uploading it to Star Wars The Last Hope. Here we go, everybody.
Oh, boy. I hope this is good for us.
Oh, despair. Holy shit. Oh! It's canceled out.
No.
Despair, though.
He has one success.
And a despair.
It's a mechanical despair.
Yeah.
Gary's a...
He...
One success and...
Disarms Gary. But there are numbers still working on it.
But the what?
Fortuna?
Huh?
You did activate the dead man switch. Well, that wasn't the only thing you turned on, apparently.
What did I turn on?
Give me a knowledge warfare check. Let's go with 3 difficulty, because let's be honest.
I know exactly what's going on here. I love it.
Do you?
It couldn't be like lore.
No, it's a grenade. It's warfare.
Okay, that's fair.
You might get it.
It's a grenade. You might get it.
Yeah, I mean, okay.
3 difficulty.
Okay.
You might just be lucky.
No.
No, you're not, but...
Not bad, though.
All I did was use the dead man switch. That's all I did. I put my finger on the thing, just like Roos said. It is now PC slot 3, I believe. No, PC slot
mystery.
2. PC slot 2. Excuse me.
Oh, yeah. Bartuna, keep running, right?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, I'd like to get as far away as possible. Action and all. They have Gary!
Hey, what? Who? Wait, what?
The Jawa is severely...
Double detonator!
Yeah, the Jawa is severely fucked up.
Right. Wobbles is as well.
What happened to you guys?
Looks at all the dead stormtroopers. Oh, you know, typical Sunday afternoon or whatever fucking day it is.
Oh, this ain't fucking good.
You're not gonna believe where Arden is right now.
Oh, yeah, he never rolled that performance check.
Not yet. He's been busy, and nobody contacted him this entire firefight.
No performance check. There was no performance checks. I was just like, I'm just going to sit here. Dude, I don't know what to do.
Dude, I think the phone call with, like, gunshots in the background would probably kill the foreplay.
Yeah.
Just probably. Saying.
Zach, got whatever, guys. I'm busy.
Okay, so
as Chaba is getting, you know, coming to the realization that they have Gary, the both of you look towards the shuttle to see the guy, the Imperial officer, has run off, holding the damn thing, looking and seeing you, and trying to throw it at you.
Oh, good thing you can't possibly throw that far.
And it probably has a big radius, though.
It's a short-range throw, unfortunately. That's the range on a thermal detonator is just short-range. So,
yeah.
I would say that he would throw it, plink.
Well, if it's now a PC slot and he hasn't yet exploded, I'm going to shoot him. If that is okay with everyone.
He is that long from you.
What was that, John? That might be important.
Oh, no. He just used his turn to...
Okay,
move, didn't he? So, yeah, we're on... Right. I think we're on a PC slot, aren't we?
Hang on a second. I completely forgot to do one thing. I forgot to find out how many rounds that thing had.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, boy.
Well, it was at least one.
He goes to throw it.
Plus,
I can't read the description. It's too small. Let me see.
Where even is Gary?
When your mouse is over the card, hit Alt.
Yeah. After a delay of up to three rounds.
Up to three rounds.
Remember, it's been at least two, right?
Not since the switch has been deactivated.
It fell
to his turn. He grabbed the device from Bortuna and turned off the dead man switch, but Bortuna didn't just activate the dead man switch when he grabbed it from his back. That's what the despair was. But I couldn't set that despair off without turning a light side point to at least give him a red, which is why I used a light side point for you guys. It was the only way I could make sure that this was a possibility. And you saw the roll.
Yeah. Yep.
He has up to three rounds to, you know, according to him, to get rid of it. But a full round is, you know, a full initiative slot. So just remember that.
It's all of us going and then back to him, right? It's like from PC slot one to PC slot one. That's a full round, right?
Correct.
Yeah, so it's been at least, well, none, I don't think.
No. It's been like half of the turn so far. So the grenade, the thermal detonator, has landed on the deck. Right there. Pretty much where one of the stormtroopers had been at one point in time. It's just tink, tink, tink. PC slot 3.
About that shooting him. Should we still do that?
You know, I have a bold suggestion, and it may be the stupidest idea I've ever come up with. Shoot the thermal detonator and make it bounce back toward him.
What if I stun him?
That's a good idea.
I'm sorry, I thought I heard you suggest that we're going to shoot Gary?
It's going to be us killing a member of the party, I know, but...
Well, he's going to die anyway.
Yeah, he's going to die.
Just plays glory. What if I shoot it and he just explodes?
Then that would be really funny. It really depends on the explosion radius, though. I don't know how large the explosion radius is.
To my understanding, it'll probably be at least medium. At least short, maybe medium. It is both.
So probably right here, maybe?
It won't reach us, I don't think. At the very least, it might just reach the tail end right behind Bortuna. If anything, he's in more of the radius, and so's his buddy back there than anybody.
Yeah, so what do you want to do? Blumbles he can't really do much. If he tries to shoot it, it won't be good, so.
Well, he has a gun, right? It's like, like a holdout pistol, but it's still a gun, right?
Correct.
Should I just shoot him?
You can either shoot to kill or shoot to stun.
What do you guys think is worse?
I think it'd be funnier if he got blew up, personally.
Then I will shoot to stun. I will aim as well.
Okay.
You're sure we can't save Gary?
I don't think we can, unfortunately. I'll be honest. I thought about running over there because I'm fairly certain I could get there with my maneuver and my action as a thing, or the strain, using strain. But then I would have to use my action to grab Gary, and he could shoot me there, and I would go down in one shot.
Yeah, no, let's not do that.
We can get another Gary, probably.
Another Gary?
Maybe even more than one Gary. I won't lie. We're losing two things I didn't want to lose here. I didn't want to lose Gary, and I didn't want to lose that Imperial officer, because I have a feeling without him, we're going to have a harder time getting the hell out of here.
Well, let's see what happens.
Yeah, I'm going to shoot to stun the guy. Does setting my gun to stun do any, like, require anything, like a maneuver or anything?
Nope, it's just a free action. Click.
Click. Fire at him. Long range, right? What in the...
You miss.
What are the odds? I'm rerolling that. We have lights out. That would be six advantages. Well, that wouldn't be six, but it'd be a lot.
Five.
I flipped your
You already did it?
Yep.
Oh, go back.
You should only have... You should have two lights out at this point.
Yep.
That's much better.
There we go.
That's one advantage and the four success. Yeah, four success.
Yeah, perfect. Dude falls over.
The dramatic music as Gary starts to glow.
No.
Please tell me he's conscious.
No, he's stunned. He's unconscious. He's out. That was what, PC slot 3?
2, I think.
No, that was 2. PC slot 3.
Yeah. Oh, okay. We were only halfway through the initiative, weren't we?
Yeah, it is 3.
Yeah, it's PC slot 3. Fortuna ran twice.
Pilot sees a guy down, sees the thermal detonator.
I ain't paid enough for this. Oh, he's making a check. I just saw that dark side flip.
With no failures, no disadvantages. Wow. Why can't this fucking work for me?
Oh no.
Wow. Okay, fuck that thing.
We'll just imagine it blew up if it blew up.
Oh no, it didn't blow up. It got shot.
No!
The dude just straight bullseyed right up underneath it, knocked it closer to you guys. PC slot 1.
Does it go off? When does it go off?
2 rounds from now, I think.
You don't know. That's the problem.
Okay, so I have 2 ideas. But it hinges on knowledge warfare or my shooting ability. My knowledge warfare is 2 green.
Your shooting ability is more.
My shooting ability is much higher, yes.
If it does go off, it's definitely going to hit you too.
Uh-oh.
If it doesn't go off, you have the potential, like the pilot did, to shoot it back at them. What are you going to do?
Oh, okay, here's a question. Theoretically, if I were to run over there and grab it and try to deactivate it, but fuck up, could I shield Fortuna from the blast with my body? Nope. In any way.
That is not happening.
Okay, not then, I will just fucking shoot it then, I guess.
You can always run over and pick it up and throw it.
Nah.
It'd and yell, Uchi! As you charge at him.
It'd be better just to shoot it. I mean, it effectively does the same thing. And I just have a better chance at doing it, I feel like. What would be the difficulty for this?
Two difficulty. It's short range, so it's one, but because it's a small object, I increase the difficulty to two.
Maneuver aim. Keep. Now.
I should have upgraded it.
Okay, that's a success.
Yeah, that's, I mean, I ain't gonna point it out because it's just straight up a success. It doesn't really necessarily matter in this situation.
Two success, two advantage.
We'll just use a pawn for Gary.
It doesn't matter at this point in time. Chance Cube, what color is your favor?
For me?
For your favor.
Red.
Roll it.
Big money, no whammy. Big money, no whammy. Yes!
Yes!
Gary goes, pa-bang. Boom. It only had one round.
Thought so.
It explodes in, you know, a small radius. I hate this thing. It doesn't do it centered.
Nah, it does it, like, to the side.
Wow, did blow that guy up. I'm not impressed.
You know, now, when you said it was going to hit us both, I thought it would be bigger than that.
Well, like again, here, the range here is hard to...
Yeah.
You know, it could be like that kind of a thing. It's just, it's hard to do it when it off-centers it instead of centers it.
Yeah. Well, I mean, even if it didn't blow the guy up, that's still beneficial for us.
As the station alarms start going off, I need a... Survival's not the right term, but it's definitely reaction. So
vigilance?
Agility? Is it vigilance?
What's the thing happening here?
Well, what we need to do? The thermal detonator just went off and just blew a hole through the deck.
Oh! Yeah.
Yep.
Well, we knew it was going to happen. Maybe even coordination at this point if we're just trying to run away. What are we, I'm assuming that this door is going to be closing or some shit, right?
Well, first I need to find out if you guys are sucked into space.
Oh.
Yeah, that's what I was afraid of.
Is the hole that big? Or is it smaller than that?
Bruh, it's a hole made by a thermal detonator.
Well, that's important, okay? If the hole is that big, probably. The answer is probably we're getting sucked out into space.
I would say that the decking is probably a meter thick. But the explosion, but the range is still a good 3 meters, maybe. So there's probably a couple meter hole at the bottom exposed to space.
Yeah, so at least a 2 meter hole. So that's about 6 feet hole. Let's see. How big is this room we're in?
Your range to the door is medium.
Okay. I'm assuming that this room is probably about the size of an aircraft hangar.
A little bit more.
A little bit bigger than that. So probably around like 400 or 500 feet wide and about the same length.
We're going to go with coordination. Escape from restraints, okay. Walking across a narrow surface, attempting to reduce damage suffered from falling, diminishing the impact by rolling into a tumble, etc.
So I'm going to that's too green. Difficulty?
Well, we're going to go with a 3. It is...
Blumbles... Since Blumbles is the farthest away and closest to the door, would his effect be left?
Because he's also got the objects right in his path to it.
I've got one advantage.
You said 3 difficulty, right?
Yeah.
Two success and 2 threat.
Nothing! Literally nothing.
I just have an advantage.
Don't forget light side, guys.
Do we have enough for both of us?
We have three light sides.
I don't think it'll help me. I'll be honest. In theory, oh, that one fell over, but it was two success. I was just moving it out.
Why did my hole disappear?
I might have erased it.
Bortuna, you can roll me another check. This time at two difficulty. This guy is Lord. Clinging. This guy is
gone.
Space. This guy is in space.
Oh no.
Oh no.
I guess I need to use a light side point.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Might be it, boys.
Oh no.
Oh. One fail, one advantage.
Oh no.
You're gonna get one more chance at this. The actual edge of the hole. Because there's a bunch of ragged crap sticking out.
Hey, wouldn't there be a bunch of stormtrooper bodies down there?
Oh, they're going towards it too.
Oh,
they're getting
no.
dragged across the deck and
no. We kill the person we're supposed to save.
That sounds about great. You guys.
Well, we didn't technically kill him. In a way, this is technically.
Oh my god.
God. The dice just wants him dead.
In a way, this is technically a suicide. Theoretically, Shaba. Anything about it.
We've Shaba. Got two light side.
I need you to roll two difficulty.
Okay.
Oh, well, never mind.
You were an Asian. This is better than last time. That's two success and one threat.
You've grabbed the edge, the top edge, at least. All right. Bortuna. I need a resilience check. And we're going to stay with the let's say three difficulty. You're now in vacuum.
Question. Just a quick hypothetical here. Just in case this light side point could be useful. Some time ago, Bortuna had an external environment suit on, mining an asteroid. It wasn't that long ago, theoretically. Could he still have that on?
No. He would have been wearing it this entire time.
Worth a shot.
I forgot to use this black dye from forever ago, by the way. My bad. Okay.
Let's see if Qui-Gon's on our side.
Please?
Nope.
God damn it.
Disadvantage.
Question is, does this do wound or strain? Oh.
Strain.
Did it just instantly set him to zero?
Yep.
He couldn't hold his breath. He's... Shaba? The air is getting awfully thin. Lumbles, you've been, you know, smacked up against the side of that because you passed your check, didn't you? Yes, yes.
Yeah, I did.
Alright.
What all is in this room? Arden. That might be
Arden.
Yes?
The alarms for the stations have been going off for a little while.
Now
there's a whole different klaxon going. Give me a piloting space check for me, please. We're gonna go with one difficulty.
Okay. One difficulty. Okay.
You know absolutely that that is an emergency sounding for a venting atmosphere. That's been hard drilled into you for a long time. You're going to put two and two together.
Okay, can I start up the ship and fly out of the hangar? and go towards the other hangar, or hangar 12.
Absolutely. Give me, we're going to stick with the one difficulty here. You've had the ship ready, because you know once those two left, it was going to be, a fight or flight type of moment.
Yeah.
So, it is getting really late. Are we going to continue, or do we want to leave it at this cliffhanger?
I want to keep going. Yeah. I want to at least finish this up.
It's you're the DM, so.
Well, Cody's the one that's got to wake up, as far as I'm aware.
I'm good.
All right. Give me another piloting check just like that. We're going to have to say that the ship's been ready, because once again, you know those two.
Yeah.
You run out, pants halfway down. Like, ah, shit.
Hell, why even do it in there? Just do it in the cockpit.
Ha.
It's his cockpit.
Three success, one threat.
Oh, yeah, you get that ship up and out. Like, you're starting to hear, comm chatter. Emergency, emergency, close. Where are you going? kind of thing going off on the comms. And you get the ship out of the hangar with no problem. Now give me a perception check. Too difficult.
Perception check. Too difficult.
Oh, come on.
Can he have a blue die because Fortuna's yellow in the vast vacuum of space?
No. He's looking for venting atmosphere at this point in time. Like I said, yes, you would have a blue die because you know what the klaxon is. You know what you're looking for.
Please matter.
Oh, not a bit.
God dang it.
We have two light side left.
It's worth it.
It is worth it.
Flip it.
No, he's already flipped it.
Yeah.
You're straining the ship a little bit at this point, getting it to careen around. You see the atmosphere pouring out the bottom of the hangar. That's not what you were expecting out of that. Piloting check, three difficulty. Because at this point in time, does everybody remember what this station looks like?
Yeah.
Yeah.
At this point in time, you're not even going around the long end. You were literally trying to cut through the ribs to get to that venting atmosphere. So, three difficulty piloting space check.
Oh, good. Woo!
The ship is surviving remarkably well right now. All things considered, you've made your way. It's not very far, not to the ship's distance. Perception check. One difficulty.
One difficulty?
We're going to go with one difficulty. Because this is a dry dock, there are lights. You have your own ship lights going on.
Yes!
Triumph! Wow.
You are seeing bodies float everywhere. You're seeing a mess of stormtroopers. You see the Imperial officer peg off the freaking windshield. And you see Bortuna.
Okay. Is that the triumph? Is that I see Bortuna?
No, that's the success. I'd say with that triumph, you also see Chaba up through the hole. Feet dangling and kicking.
I noticed some little Jawa toes anywhere.
Considering how we couldn't see shit earlier, it's amazing.
Okay. Can I kind of like, I don't know how to word it. I was going to say, it's like, can I open up
the hungry, hungry hippos?
Yeah, pretty much. Like, not with the ramp, but with the cargo hold opening.
Absolutely. One more piloting check. Let's go with two difficulty.
Nice.
That's all I needed.
I'm gonna split your stream between you and your ship.
Oh yeah, that's fine. Like I'm stressing the hell out. I'm putting the ship under strain that it shouldn't be going through.
The cargo bay, the lift drops, you know, open pretty quickly. Chaba.
Yeah.
Red or blue in your favor?
Always red, my dude.
That was so weird. Not
flip. Blue.
I don't see the ship, or I get sucked out and die.
No. As Arden is flipping the ship into place to scoop up, you know, Bortuna like a hungry, hungry hippo, Asp droid was not secured properly.
No, loader! Yeah, I can fix it.
You successfully scoop up Bortuna. He's like nice. Smacking across the top of the cargo bay, you know, kind of a thing. Just because when you opened the bay, you didn't like remove the air peacefully. You just opened the bay.
Man, no, just opened it.
Which is why Loader got sucked out.
Yeah,
am I still even conscious right now?
No, you are not.
I didn't think I would be.
No. As a matter of fact, give me a resilience check. Let's go with three difficulty. We're going to use the system for something it's never been anticipated for.
Oh, no.
Ow, that's two fail, one threat.
Two wounds. You are dying.
What
are you going to do at this point in time? Chaba and Blumbles and, you know, fucking Arden is, you know, outside underneath the hole and nobody
Blumbles,
knows it, basically.
Blumbles is going to try and make his way over to Chaba. He's going to, like, get down and crawl toward him.
Can Chaba see the ship below us?
No. I would say no, you would not be able to.
Okay, then. He would probably turn his attention toward the pilot deck. Does he look like he's having a hard time?
He's hanging on to the edge of the shuttle. You know, one of the ramp. You know,
I can see Blumbles crawling towards me then, right?
I'd say yes. You grab the edge of the hole.
Okay, then I'm gonna like look to the shuttle and look to Blumbles, and I'm gonna yell out as loud as I really can. We probably have to take that fucking thing. I don't know where Bortuna is, but maybe we can get him with it.
Blumbles is just gritting his teeth, Wookiee focus, making his way over to Chaba.
Give me a coordination check, please.
Oh,
same
no.
Same difficulty that you've got on deck.
Okay.
Lying down now.
So, three difficulty?
Mm-hmm. Well, now he's moving.
Yeah, okay, true. Four success.
You're going to pick up a black die for the next thing. You're still about short range from Chaba.
Okay, so where would that put me? Right here?
You're still holding on to the edge of the crates, which is apparently fucking secured to the deck, because none of them have moved.
Bumbles is going to use this opportunity to lower himself, like, crouch first, holding onto the crates, and he's going to grab onto the flooring, if it's, like, grady. Is it grady, or is it, like, solid?
We're going to say it's grated, but not as much as you think.
Okay, and, this is actually a difficult choice for, Blumbles. Seeing, like, Chaba in danger, his life debt, debtor, in trouble, he's actually going to unsheath his Wookiee claws, breaking one of the Wookiee traditions. To try and hold on.
Give me another resilience with a blue die.
Okay.
Do Wookiees have cat claws? Is that a thing?
They have claws. But they can't unsheathe them unless they're climbing trees, which is like a Wookiee code thing. Oh, it's a three. It's three, actually. Alright, so what's the check?
The black die is good? Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to actually separate these two a little bit. Okay.
Yes. That's good.
One success, one threat.
You are climbing along the fucking deck. Give me a perception check real quick.
Okay.
Let's go with two difficulty. You guys always seem to have so much problem with two difficulty.
Why are you like this?
Listen, do you want it exciting or do you want it boring?
That's fair.
This is pretty exciting
right now.
It's the two difficulty and then whatever your perception is.
You're only saying that because you're safe in an atmosphere.
I'm saying it's pretty exciting at the moment.
It is, though.
I flipped it for some reason. There we go. And on my light side, let's see what happens. Okay, one success, one advantage.
As you have reached Chaba at the edge of the pit into the void, you're hearing above the rushing out of the air, the doors are closing to the hangar. Everything is still in this red light because, you know, the lights were out. But you see underneath, you know, the hole, it looks like your ship. Why in the fuck is your ship out there?
That's a good question. Is the opening of the cargo bay facing us still?
I would say with that amount of perception, you wouldn't know. No. Let's go with that advantage. That advantage says, yeah, you can see the bay open. It's just that much.
All right, Blumbles is going to look at Chaba and say, and yell over the sound of the vacuum of space, "You have to trust me!" And he's going to grab Chaba, like pull him close, and let himself fly towards the cargo bay.
I'm surprised you aren't just holding his face. You know, just to stop any air loss.
Come on, slam, and welcome to the jam as he slam dunks me into the cargo hold. Fucking Michael Jordan style.
I thought about it, but now he's
off. It's good.
Yeah, Bubbles is pretty much just gonna grab him, like basically curl into a ball with Chaba on his chest and try to fly into the hangar.
Arden.
Cannonball.
Yes. You see the toes of the Jawa, and then you see the hair of the Wookiee, and then you see them dive out the hole.
Okay.
The bay to the cargo hold is still open with, you know, Bortuna in there. You just gotta hold it steady. And then you hear them kunk kunk up against the roof as well.
Okay. I immediately shut it and start filling it with air. Letting it repressurize.
Give me a perception check. One difficulty.
Oh, come on. This music's so fitting.
Holy goddamn.
You guys had your triumphs, it's my turn.
Oh my god.
Everybody's inside. You can see the air returning to the cargo bay, and you're starting to see blips up on the screen as the Imperials are starting to come to the station. From the various Star Destroyers and other ships in the area.
Alright, I think it's time to GTFO.
Oh my god, what's going on? Are we going to Tatooine?
Yes! We are, right now!
Astrogation. Let's go with three difficulty for the stress of the situation. And you hadn't had it queued up and ready and set and everything, so.
Either you broads know how to work this computer.
Oh, no.
Serious? That's what I get for boasting about my turn getting triumphs.
Well, either you broads know how to work this computer?
Well, you've got some proficiencies in there, so, shit, I don't fucking know. When you start punching in coordinates, it starts giving you a list of, like, the next five available systems within that particular jump range. But it doesn't set a course for a system.
Stupid. Dang. Ah!
Hang on. I've got a lot of crap going on right now. A lot of stuff in my head. Gotta unlock this thing. Delete it. Delete that pilot. He's no longer involved here. Yes, I was drawing on this fucking table.
I'll be damned.
Can I have a meta question? Or I guess it's sort of meta. Did the pilot make it or did he die?
At this point in time, you don't know.
Let's check. We don't know.
My
well,
best
of course, educated. I don't know. That's why I'm asking.
My best educated guess would be he probably died because he's in a hangar. I don't think he has an EVA suit on.
Nope. The hangar door is closed to prevent the rest of the station from, you know, depressurizing. It's a hole in the deck, you know. They've got to send out, like, a repair crew to that section, basically. The thermal detonator, like, destroyed the system that was in place to try and seal the deck, you know. So. What the hell? Okay. Anyway. I think that might... What the... Are we losing people?
Oh, shit.
Yeah, we lost everybody.
Huh?
Everybody fell out of my game. Hello? Hello? Can you guys hear me?
Hello?
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 What just happened?
Am I back?
Everybody left my game.
See, that's the thing. It's like I saw Rocky disconnect. I'm like, hello? Because it was getting really, really quiet.
Yeah.
I was like, hello?
Did the Earth just get hit with a solar flare or something? That was weird.
Yeah.
That was weird.
Discord is still loading for me, so I might have to force end it and rejoin the call. So I'm gonna do that right fast.
Yeah, it just won't let me.
Don't leave just yet, because you can still hear us. This is where we're gonna end.
This is where we're gonna end. Okay.
Oh, this is where we're gonna end.
Oh, that was probably the most nerve-wracking, like, final 15 minutes I've ever had in a game.
Yes.
I'm
yes.
Ending
oh God.